Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Tauqeer once again. I wanted to record a video about the importance of the terms used in the Quran to address human beings. Interestingly, the Quran is so deep, so comprehensive, and so beautiful that there is so much to learn from, and every day you learn more and more. I wanted to talk about today the word Insaan and Bashar. So both of these terms are used in the Quran to describe human beings. The word Insaan comes from the root word Nisyan, which means forgetfulness, and Uns, which means familiarity. So sometimes, in some places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order to address human beings, He uses the word Insaan. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing us by saying Insaan, He is addressing the spiritual and the intellectual needs of human beings. And other times, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the word Bashar. Bashar literally means skin. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the word Bashar to describe human beings, He is addressing the physical needs of a human being. Now what we learn from that is that a human being has two components. He is a composition of two elements, or I guess two parts, which is the physical aspect and the spiritual aspect. And most often we only focus on the physical needs, such as eating and drinking and sleeping and natural disposition of a physical nourishment or physical needs of a body. We rarely focus and think about the intellectual needs of a human being. But interestingly, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directs our attention to both of these needs. The second thing that we need to understand is that both intellect and the physical aspect of human beings are connected to each other. Now, when it comes to the physical aspect of a human being, it is dependent on the intellect, whereas our intellect is not dependent on the physical aspect of a human being. For instance, a man can be alive and healthy in terms of his mind capacity by not having the physical organs. So that goes to show that the intellect is not dependent on the physical body. The third thing I want to talk about, and what we take from this, is that human beings have two components, and we rarely focus on the intellect and the spiritual needs of human beings, of us. We only focus on the physical needs and the physical nourishment. We eat and drink and sleep, and we do all of the things that are required by our physical body or our physical organs, but we rarely do anything that is nourishment for our brain and for our spirituality. And what is the intake? How do we nourish our brain, our intellect, and our spirituality? That is by using the five senses, right? The five senses is the ability to see, hear, smell, taste, and feel. This is what brings nourishment, right? A person can do physical activity and he can be physically strong and have strength, but how does he nourish his mind? Is by what he intakes into his mind, by seeing, by hearing, you know, and by smelling. And that is, if you intake through these five senses, if your intake is good, then that is the nourishment of a mind, of your mind. If your intake through these five senses is not good, then it will corrupt and it will make your mind evil and bad. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Ala bi dhikrillahi tatma'innul qulub," that surely in the remembrance of Allah do hearts find rest. So in order to nourish our mind, in order to nourish our spirituality, our intellect, we need to make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time, we need to be very cautious, mindful, and vigilant of what we see and what we hear. Remember, what you see and what you hear will have an impact on your mind, and your mind will think and react in such a manner. If your intake is pure and good, then your mind and your intellect and your spirituality will also be pure as well.